so sad that they don't make air-powered super soakers anymore. I wonder if someone could build one.
Hey guys, we're Evan and Caitlin. Today we're gonna try building a water blaster using spare plumbing parts and this bike pump.
So this should work kind of like a super soaker. We're gonna have air pressure that pushes the water through a nozzle, out as a stream, and hopefully hit some targets. So we're gonna assemble the pieces together and then we'll go over what all the different parts are. This is a little wobbly. I think we're gonna 3D print some reinforcements.
This actually looks really cool for how janky this is. But first test, does it hold pressure or are there crazy leaks? So let's pump it up a little bit. Not hearing any leaks, but we should get some pressure releasing from here when this fires. Ready?
Yeah. Oh, I felt it! Yeah! That's awesome!
Nice! So now we just gotta put some water in here and see how this works.
Before we do, do you wanna explain what all the parts are?
Okay, we have the bike pump right here. It's going through a one-way valve right here into this main assembly. And there's gonna be air right here, water right here, and this clear part so we can see how much fuel or ammo we have left. And we have this trigger right here, which is basically a fast-acting valve. The one thing we're missing is a nozzle so the water just doesn't spray out all at once. We want it to be like a concentrated pew. So we're gonna make one using this little plug right here. Alrighty, so now it's time to test. And one special feature we have is this pressure gauge right here. So we can like test it at different pressures and see how it performs. Should we go?
Let's do it.
75 PSI.
Whoa! Oh, don't shoot it at me!
This works really well!
That's awesome!
So good! Alright, so good news is that it seems like all of the components work. The pressure pump, the valve, nothing's really leaking too much. But there are also a few things that I already know we need to change. The reservoir isn't big enough, I kind of predicted that. And the nozzle is going through the water a little bit too fast. The last thing is kind of weird to like pump up here and fire down. Fire down here. The main reason why I designed it like this is so that I didn't have to have a hose going into the reservoir. When things are oriented this way, the water is always going to be at the bottom, but functionally, this isn't the best. New design, let's see how it works. Woo! So there's still that. You still have to tilt it.
So our attempts at making our own nozzle didn't work super well. So we're gonna try 3D printing a new nozzle instead.
We're also having a problem with air getting to the nozzle instead of 100% water, especially when we tilt it. We're gonna have to have a hose going into the reservoir, which allows us to flip it around. And while we're at it, we're gonna add a bigger reservoir. Here we have this bushing that leads to the nozzle, this piece right here. And we wanna have this go all the way down to the reservoir. And we're gonna do that by adding this barbed fitting and then this hose right here, like that. But there's no threads here, so we're gonna have to add the threads first.
So now we need to take this tube and feed it through here, and it should come out here. So we're worried that the hose is gonna get too twisted as we screw this in, so what we're gonna do is twist it backwards first, and then as we screw it in, it should untwist.
When we went to design our new nozzle, we wanted to smooth out the turbulent flow into laminar flow. So we added a grid of parallel tubes in front of the nozzle, which should help straighten out the stream. We had no clue if we could print details this tiny, but went for it anyways and were honestly blown away by this SLA print. Okay, now to answer a question you've been dying to ask us, where did we get these t-shirts from?
You can get yours at shopevanandkaitlin.com. Okay, go for it.
Woo! That's awesome!
Whoa! Ah!
I'm really happy. So we have solved the nozzle problem, the reservoir problem. We have solved
the gravity problem.
The air going in instead of water.
No, we solved gravity.
But this is it. Functionally, this does everything we wanted to.
It does work, but we want to tinker with it just a little bit more. So we're going to do two things. One is currently this is where we fill up the water from. I'm not gonna unscrew it all the way, but it'd be way more convenient if we could fill it up from this end instead. So we're gonna swap this around, and then we're gonna 3D print a few things to make holding this easier. Also, now that we know we can 3D print our own bullets, we're gonna experiment.
Bullets? You mean the nozzles?
Nozzle! Now that we know we can 3D print our own nozzles, we're gonna experiment with a few things and see if we can make it even better. This is the wrong size.
Okay, looking for.
We have to test it against the super soakers you can buy today.
To give them a fighting chance, we got one of the best ones out there in terms of range. The Breech Blast claims 38 feet, so let's see how they do. It's hardly leaking. Alrighty. Oh.
Can you see where it's going?
Kind of like 30, 35.
Okay, let's see. It's hitting mostly 30. Oh, there's a couple drops that barely made it to 38. Hey, I have a camera! It was not much power made it to the 38. It was like a few droplets. The bulk of it hit between 20 and 30 feet.
It ran out of water really fast too.
Ran out of water real fast. Mm. Okay, we're gonna test ours now.
Ready, fire!
Woo!
What's the verdict?
Okay, so I'll be honest. I thought this was gonna go like 60 feet. I thought it was gonna be insane. It shot about the same distance, but I will say that it's a lot quicker to fire. You can boom, 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 rapid fire this, whereas the ones you buy, every single shot you have to pump. So
this one requires more prep, but it's good to go right away.
And it's good to go for a long time. Yeah, exactly.
All right, so now, wanna do a verse off? A little like pew pew competition?
I'll do a pew pew competition with you. Ready?
Fire.
Really slippery. Okay, I'm done. No.
All right, so after all that testing, who wants the store-bought one?
Oh, shoot.
Who wants the one that we made? It still has some issues that don't make it 100% perfect, but we love it because we made it and it's special to us.
It's our first one, yeah.
Yeah, so if you think that this is special too, you are in luck because we are giving this away thanks to our sponsor, Carolina.
It's actually part of a joint giveaway we're doing with Carolina and Paul Jackman, so he's giving away a merged wood cookie wall art, and we'll have links below to his video and to the giveaway details, so definitely check those out.
See you next time.
No. I think we're gonna...
To give them a fight.
Whoa, look at that.
Terrorizing people.
Look at the camera like
Paul Jackman style.
Paul Jackman style.
Yeah, you got a little.
Didn't see you guys over there. All right, guys, if you've stayed this far in the video, you are awesome and you might be interested in something that we do for every video. We record an after show.
We talk about behind the scenes stuff, like for this one, the wedding we were trying not to disturb.
Using our drone again, which was so fun. So if that sounds interesting to you, head over to patreon.com/Evan and Caitlin to get the after show, plus sneak peeks and behind the scenes stuff, lots of other goodies. Hope to see you there. Bye.
Bye.
Last one was good.
I was holding up my fingers because I was going to do three things, and we only did two, and then I just kept holding. Yeah.